This is the original opening to episode 109 as scripted. We changed the opening for a couple of reasons. One was that on the page we had always said we wanted this to be an episode that was told primarily from Jamie's point of view. And when we put the cut together, however, I felt that the idea of Jamie's point of view wasn't coming through quite strongly enough. So I said, let's open the episode closer to the way we opened the original pilot with Jamie's voiceover. And so I asked for a series of second unit shots of sort of Scottish landscape. So that then defines sort of the opening sequence. As a result, this scene that you're about to watch plays much longer, has more air in it, it takes its time, because it was originally intended to be the opening of the entire episode and of the second half of the season. Once we decided to put Jamie's voiceover in, this scene had a different sort of feeling to it in context, so we paced it up and cut some time out of it. The second reason why this scene changed radically was basically the overall runtime of 109, which was one of our longest episodes. So we were looking throughout the entire episode, looking for cuts and trims. We paced this scene up considerably, took some pieces of dialogue out. I also slid the information about Ned Gowan saying that he didn't want any of them to have loaded weapons. We sort of added that in ADR, additional dialogue off camera, and other scenes to sort of backtrack and cover why that happened. But this is the original opening, the way it was intended.
Where's your mind, lad? We're here for you. Ask him what you came for.
Now that you've washed the dust from your throat, Mr. Horrocks, I'd be obliged if you tell us what happened that night at Fort William.
Did you or did you not tell Hugh Munro you saw who shot the sergeant?
I did. Forgive me, but I haven't tasted fine whiskey like that in quite some time. I could use another wee nip.
I'm eager that you name the person who committed the crime I was falsely accused of.
Have you the gold Hugh Munro promised you'd pay? Well, hand it over. We move on with the business.
The name first.
You'll have it when I have the gold in my hand. I mean, that was the understanding.
Give him the gold. I'll trust his word.
The British Army trusted him too.
Perhaps today's not such a good day for business after all.
Whether you desert it, it's no concern of ours, Mr. Horrocks.
We commend you for it.
I've come a long way. A considerable danger to myself, eluding Redcoat patrols.
Jan Tors.
The man who shot the sergeant was Captain Jonathan Randall himself.
You expect us to believe that a captain, even one as vile as Black Jack, would shoot his own man?
You know Randall. I suppose you can answer that.
I can't use Randall's name to clear my own.
You bargained for a name is what you received. Good day, lads.
No. Let him go.
Jamie! Jamie!
There. I was minding her, I swear. I went for a piss.
Where is she?
She must have wandered off. When I caught up, the Redcoats had her. She was fighting and thrashing about, but they took her. They were headed south.
Hold now. Fort William. I know what's on your mind, lad, but what you're thinking is impossible.
I'm going, with or without you.
Dougal and I must abstain from any open action against the British garrison. If we were captured, then the consequences upon the clan and Colin would be... Oh, no. No, the risk is too great, I'm afraid.
If any man wants to ride with you, I'll no stop him.
I'm not beseeching anyone for help. I'm also not proud enough to turn it down.
I'll go with you.
I'm not doing anything special today. A wee raid might be amusing.
Amusing?
Oh, aye.
Fine. But there are conditions you will have to heed.